Welcome, mortals, to the Charlotte Latin Middle School production of Xanadu Jr. on the direct stage here in T's Auditorium. I am Zeus, god of the sky and father of all gods and even you minions.
And I'm Hermes, messenger to the gods. And I bring a message of thanks to the Latin Arts Association, Friends of Theater Arts, the middle school administration, teachers, parents...
Enough! This list of mortals is making me feel weak and uninspired. The year is 1980, and all creativity is stymied. Like this musical here. Remind me what it's about?
Oh, do you know the band Electric Light Orchestra?
Sounds like a smiting festival.
Well, they gave some of their music to a movie this year, and well, it really flopped. So we thought that we'd celebrate it with roller skates and an improbable story.
Only mere mortals would participate in such idiocracy.
Just a reminder to the audience, you can anticipate flashing lights or light patterns, so proceed with caution if you experience epileptic seizures or blackouts when exposed.
From my magnificent thunderbolts?
No, the disco balls.
I don't understand.
Please recycle your programs and silence your phones. Let's start the show!
Oh, hey, I didn't know you guys were here. There's a lot of you, like a crowd or something. But, oh man, I love when this happens. When a whole bunch of regular, everyday people just walking along a nice California beach here in Venice stop to look at this beautiful chalk mural. For me, that's what art is. Just proves that art isn't for the wealthy or the well-educated. Or even the intelligent, but for people like you. I call this piece the Ancient Greek Artichokes. I did a ton of research on it. I took a book out of the library even. But the girl in the middle isn't quite right. Never mind, it doesn't matter. What does matter is that we are all gathered here today for an artistic experience. One where the girl up front and center is all wrong. It throws off the whole composition. I mess up everything I do and I'll never, ever, ever get it right. Mega bomber. Whatever. Guys like me shouldn't dream anyway.
Really? to achieve truly great work.
True that, Sister Cleo.
Word. And with our guidance, perhaps this artist shall create the greatest art of all. The stars are aligned, are they not? Is this not Venice? Is this not the dawn of the 80s?
Yes, sweet sister and mistress of all muses. Meant to bring that up. This isn't Venice, Italy. This is Venice, California. And this isn't 1780. This is 1980.
Ew.
So in terms of art, we are so gonna have our work cut out for us.
And as surely as we are the offspring of Zeus, I tell you that I will go in disguise to help this Sonny Malone in his quest for artistic achievement.
Huzzah!
But Cleo, you know the rules. An artist must never find out he's been inspired by a muse. Otherwise, how could there be an artist's ego? Right you are. To pronounce one's museness is as forbidden as creating art or loving a mortal.
Loving a mortal?
Good one.
But what can you do to remain unnoticed?
I shall go in disguise.
A disguise? Tell us of this disguise.
Firstly, I will not call myself Cleo. I will call myself Kira.
Throwing them all off the tracks now.
Secondly, I will wear leg warmers.
You shall be as current as today's headlines.
And thirdly, I will sport an Australian accent. Good eye, mine. I tell you, sisters, by the fires of Hephaestus, I mean, by the fires of all the shrimp on the barbay, I shall help this Sonny Malone to fulfill his destiny.
Huzzah!
Muses all, let us announce our callings and rejoice to the new world.
Cleo!
Muse of history and leader of the muses, hereafter known as Kira.
Nerato!
Muse of lyrics!
Urania!
Muse of astronomy!
Polyhenia!
Muse of sacred song!
My sisters and I begin our task.
Goodbye, cruel world. Even my goodbye notes are cliche. Here, let's keep this simple. Here was an artist who tried and failed. There, that ought to make him cry. The jerks. All right. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Good eye, mine. What are you doing at the edge of
you please leave me alone?
You're angry and you're hurt because you doubt your own artistic abilities.
Why do artists always have to hate whatever they create before they even finish it?
Saves time.
Hey, do I know you?
Sydney, Melbourne, the Outback.
I've never been there.
They call me Kira, which is good, because that's my name. Sunny Malone, I believe in you, even if I'm the only one in the world.
I promise I'll bring it back.
Sure, as long as you bring it back.
Thank you. Kira, wait up!
Oh, muses, rejoice!
We rejoice with abandon!
Notice how we do inspire the humans here in Los Angeles and Orange counties.
Inspiration here, it would seem, is received as water in a land of drought.
Ooh, snap this.
Ah, muses.
Huzzah to Cleo, leader of the muses.
As I am being pursued by the mortal they call Sunny Malone, my intercourse with you must be fleeting.
Yes, my younger and exceedingly immature sister. I do notice your labors with this human are more than ardent. Are you falling in love with him, or do you simply wish to create art yourself?
You speak with a serpent's tongue, my old, old, ancient, and potentially senile sister. I know that for muses to create is forbidden by Zeus himself, almost as forbidden as falling in love with a mortal. My intentions with the one they call Sunny Malone are purely selfish, for Zeus has appeared to me in dreams and told me that one day soon I shall inspire art so wondrous that I will be granted the gift of Xanadu.
Xanadu?
Xanadu, the gift so grand that none of us truly know what it is.
Zeus tells me he will be sending me a sign, and now I must go and inspire great work.
Sweet muses of inspiration, let us attend to our various charges.
Calliope, hasten hither.
I'm already hither.
I crave a word with you. I need not tell you, as firstborn, I was entitled to the position of leader of the muses.
And yet Zeus did not grant thusly. What gives?
Achelous.
The river god?
He was a river god, and he was a rambling man. He left me with my daughters, Molpe, Paisonoe, Thepsepia.
Like a Jennifer or Susan would have killed you.
Yes, my daughters. For years, I instructed them in the lute and the flute, and now they sit by the seaside, singing and playing and luring sailors to their rocky deaths. Yes, my daughters, the sirens.
And Zeus did not grant you the leader position because he felt you'd be too busy with your children, so we gave the role to Cleo.
Apparently there is no success nor joy for you nor I, and now Cleo is to be granted Xanadu. Would that I were a god, I would smite her!
Oh, sister, sister, you are so... What's the expression I'm looking for? You're a...
evil woman!
Da-da-da-da-da-da!
Evil woman!
Da-da-da-da-da-da!
Evil woman!
Da-da-da-da-da!
Evil woman!
Roaming from another town, it's some good to watch to settle.
place, and where have I seen this before? Oh, I know! This is the place in the background of the mural. I've been painting it and painting it all this time, and I've never seen it till now. It's like how the face of the girl I was painting turned out to be Kira. Who am I talking to? Oh, it's you.
It's me. Hi.
But this could be the perfect place to open my apex of all the arts, my roller disco. But what to call it?
How about Sunny's Place?
Righteous, but let's chill out. I think I see an old marquee in the bush over there.
What does it say?
It says Xanadu.
Xanadu? Sunny, that sign is a sign.
Of course it is, silly.
Oh, yes, I'm just being silly. But Xanadu.
Kira, I don't even know you, but let me tell you, you are the best thing that's ever happened to me.
Thank you, and you're probably right.
I wonder who owns this old white elephant. There's a sign on the door over there, but I wonder how to get a hold of him.
If only there were a book, a magic book, that listed all the locations in Los Angeles and had their phone numbers listed next to them.
Yeah.
And if that book had pages the color of amber?
I know. I'll look it up in the phone book.
My God, you're brilliant.
It's ringing. Landlord of this place. He has an office in downtown LA.
Downtown LA?
Don't worry. You make me feel so invincible. I feel like I can go into downtown LA without protection.
Come on, May.
Kira? A little help, please?
Now, my sister in evil, now do we step now?
The curse of love? So early in their exchange? Nay, sister, if she were to feel love, she could dismiss it as a crush. Or even worse,
a passing fancy.
And what of Cleo and her mortal? Where do they journey off to? I wonder out loud.
$1 million! Miss Frelinghuysen, please send in my next appointment. I believe it's a Mr. Sonny Malone and Associate. McGuire here. I will destroy you! Have a nice day. You must be Sonny Malone. Where's the associate?
Oh, I guess she'll be here in a little while.
Why are you here?
I'm here to talk to you about renting one of your spaces.
You have to be a little more specific. I own many, many buildings here in the Los Angeles area.
Right, right. Of course. I'm here to talk to you about a space you own down on Fairfax.
Oh, yes. I'm tearing the whole block down, turning it into condos.
Well, there's this theater there. It's called the Xanadu, and...
The Xanadu? I haven't thought about that fire trap in years, but what for? You're going to run movies in there or something?
Well, yeah, movies, live theater performances, and oh, there's also going to be an art gallery.
Visionary. But I mean in a good way. Us developers just love the arts.
You do?
Sure. Nothing turns a neighborhood around like the arts. Then you can kick out the artists and sell it for more to the urban professionals.
Oh, that's nice. There's also going to be an athletic element to this endeavor. I would like to open a roller disco.
How much money do you have to spend?
I was sort of thinking you might give it to me for free.
Me? Give you one of my properties for free?
Well, it would have all the arts in one place, so people could come in.
Just say the free part again, because that's just comedy in a bag there.
Besides, you're not using it in... It shouldn't be torn down. It's a great old theater.
I should know. I built it.
You did?
My very first building. Never opened it.
Then it's been sitting empty all these years. Then why don't you just...
Why don't you stop talking and go away?
How's it going, Mai?
You! I said you'd be back and... No, it can't be you!
Sorry?
No, I'm sorry. You just look like someone I once knew and I wasn't much... younger man. Like this guy over here, only I didn't show so much leg. Why do you seem familiar?
They call me Kira.
Kira? Sorry, lady. You just look like someone I once knew. Now, get out of here. The both of you. And forget about the Xanadu. I'm tearing the whole place down.
No other face could take you off my mind. You're so refined. I have to warn you, I'm never gonna set you free, 'cause I was born to love you for eternity.
Whenever you're away from me, wherever you go, you're never far away from me. I want you to
from Alabama.
Showing up as sure as you're born, you blow my wig, Daddy.
Featured the theater and I built it just for you. What should we label it?
How about the Xanadu?
Kill me, kill me! How's about this clarinet player just laying down the last spin on the construction?
But how do you ever afford such an expensive theater? Of just the dough you get from playing a liquor stick.
That song I wrote about you, the Duke says it's solid gold.
But do you really think I'm a sophisticated lady?
None other, Duchess. None other.
That's the first song I want to hear once we open this place. Once we build this theater, we're going to have Big Bang concerts in here. The joint will be jumping with jitterbugs.
Only, now that I've looked over the books and everything, well, let's not open right now.
What?
The timing's wrong. We're fighting the Germans and the Japanese, and times is tough.
So you're saying just because we're in two wars and a depression, it's not time for art? So you don't want to open theater until times are better, because they would probably lose money, man.
Bingo, you dig.
I'm going to leave you, Danny. And 35 years from now, when a young man comes to your door and asks for you to rent this theater, you will put aside your greed and help him.
Wait a minute. You didn't say that to me when we broke up.
But I'm saying it now, during this flashback. If you ever loved me, give the kid a break. You better never stray, 'cause I'll never be far away.
You better never stray, 'cause I'll never be far away.
What are we doing in a theater?
Come along, center of the stage, past this discarded scenery.
Ooh, scenery!
Calliope! No chewing on the scenery! This is where once and for all we shall put a curse on Kira and her mortal Sunny, and we shall make them fall in love.
Why do mortals fall in love?
Oh, well, there are many reasons why mortals fall in love. For some it is lust, for others companionship. For a few in the San Fernando Valley, it is simply because the other one has air conditioning. But we shall make them fall in love in the most lethal way known. We shall make them complete one another.
Girl, you're a menace.
Off do we go. Let us hide and complete our evil mission. No, let us not giggle. Let us cackle.
How about I giggle and you cackle?
Delio, you start.
Hello? Hello? Is anybody here? There's a light in here. I just broke in because I wanted to see where my dream almost happened.
Hey, what are you doing? Oh, it's you. This is private property.
I know. I was just leaving.
Hey, is that girl from the office here? She's a remarkable girl. You don't see a face like that every day.
She's one foxy lady.
The idea you had, the two of you had, it was her idea too, right? They're doing concerts in here?
Well, yeah, it's going to be more than concerts, though. It's going to be...
See, now you're annoying me. Why do you keep talking? I had that idea too, a long time ago. Concerts. In this theater. Classy stuff. Swing music and three girls singing in tight, tight unison.
Thank you.
Yeah, man. This could be awesome.
You want this theater? If you fix it up by this afternoon, I'll give you and the girl 25%.
But that's impossible.
Yeah, I didn't think you had it in you.
Hey, now. Hey. Just because it's impossible doesn't mean I'm not going to do it.
All right, Bright Eyes. You fix this up by sundown.
Kira! Kira!
Sonny, what is it?
If we fix this theater up by sundown today, the owner's going to let us have 25%. It's a great deal, isn't it?
It's a terrible deal. And the task is impossible.
Kira, I feel like I'm on the brink of complete and total artistic fulfillment. Oh, I could use a fresca.
Now you have me enthusiastic and as jumpy as a joey.
Let's draw up the plans of what this place is going to be. Here, you draw too.
Oh, I can't actually do the artwork. There are strict rules against...
Can you draw the lobby for me?
Well, I'm a terrible drawer.
Just draw.
It's awful.
No need to be so hard on yourself.
But I did it, and it's there. No wonder those dealing with mortality delight so in creation.
Come on now. You're not such a bad drawer.
Oh, Sonny, I think you're wonderful.
Now my sister.
Now my sister. Sailing softly through the sun in a broken snow-day it's dawn. You fly.
Accomplish this restoration in the time allotted, not even with the help of my muses, who have just happened by.
Muses?
Oh, yes, my muses. And even with these most powerful muses, it is not possible.
Not possible? Not for Sonny Malone. Stick with me, little muses. A 1, 2, 3, 4!
Thank you.
come and go so quickly here?
I'll tell you, when I made that deal, I assumed you never could do it.
Why'd you give up on this place?
What I can tell you. I loved a girl. Heck of a girl. She inspired me. She brought out the best in me. But I wanted to make money, so I let go of a lot of my dreams. Suddenly, the guy I was gone. And the girl was gone, too.
I get that, man. But how about this theater? I said I'd fix this place up, and I did!
You didn't. What do you know? I'm back in the show business.
In Xanadu did Kublai Khan a stately pleasure dome decree.
Where Alph the sacred river ran through caverns measureless to man, down to a sunless sea. That's you, isn't it, Kitty?
I'm not Kitty. I'm Kira.
Why, of course not. If you were Kitty, then you'd be much, much... You'd be my age. Unless...
Unless?
If you ever see a girl who looks a lot like you, only she's my age now and Southern and has the name Kitty, please tell her that I loved her very much and I was a fool and that I never loved again.
Well, that would be an awful lot for me to say to someone I just met. But I'm sure wherever she is, she knows it.
Well, I'm gonna go see how the sign looks from the back of the house.
This is all because of you, Kira. Don't you feel it?
I have a sense of foreboding. Something terrible.
I can't...
You gotta, come on! Gotta see the sign from back here!
Sign?
The Xanadu.
Xanadu?
The Xanadu sign?
Xanadu sign?
People will see this and just die.
They'll love it!
People will die and love Xanadu sign?
Hurry up! The sign is so clear anybody could see it.
Oh, Sunny, why don't you go run back with Danny? I'll just stay here and do some last-minute details.
Come on!
All right. See you later.
Good day, Mai.
Leo.
Oh, it is you, Hermes, the fleet-footed messenger of the gods. What brings you to me, Hermes?
Leo. I have a message from Zeus.
Yes, Hermes.
He wishes to know if you have seen his sign.
Yes, Hermes, I have seen his sign.
He also wishes you to know that the punishment for creating art is eternal damnation in the netherworld.
I am aware of that. You may tell Zeus.
And thirdly, he wishes you to know that the punishment for loving a mortal is eternal damnation in the netherworld.
Hermes, why does Zeus tell me these things? I love no one. I have created nothing. I am an ageless, loveless, uncreative being. Why does Zeus accuse me so, Hermes? Why?
Girl, I don't know your life.
Oh, Zeus, I hear your warnings. Now I must run away from this Sunny Malone who has stolen my heart.
You would have to be blind not to see that sign staring you in the face.
Sunny, please stop talking. It hurts.
Kira, don't be such a bummer.
Sadly, bummer I am and bummer I shall be. Sunny, it is here I must take my leave of you.
Leave of me? Like, leave me?
I must go.
But you can't go. The whole Xanadu thing, I need you here.
Surely you can do this without me. And once the Xanadu Club is open and thriving, you shall pause for a moment and reflect upon us. And wherever I might be, I will know that we'll always have this Rilla Disco.
Yeah, but I need you just to be around.
Stuff and nonsense. We've only met a moment earlier. We do not know each other well enough to have any sort of significant ties. Do we?
I guess you're right and all, but I don't walk away!
No, Sunny, no! This is forbidden! I must fly! Fly like the wind!
Why do I say? Empty.
she's in love with him. It has worked beyond my wildest dreams. Now, follow my lead.
Oh, Comedy Real Estate? That's a strange name for a company.
We're looking for high-end housing for celebrities. I understand you're gonna tear this theater down, well, turn it into condos.
I'm more of an artist now.
Artist, yeah. So if you guys rage can carry on a tire on the head.
I do feel a bit foolish, I'll admit.
Yeah, tear this theater down, turn it into condos.
Well, I'd have to take that up with my partner.
Partner? Oh, and is that in writing?
No, but I couldn't.
Yeah, tear this theater down, turn it into condos.
Our pockets are, how do you say, deep.
Talk about it.
I have fallen in love with a mortal.
Not that Parker Stevenson, for I too find him a dreamboat, but I've resisted.
I should have known I'd find you here on the beach.
Oh, Sonny, I'm afraid that I'm in love with you, and now I must leave for all eternity.
Wow. You are so complicated. Because the fact of it is that I'm in love with you.
Oh, no, stop. I cannot hear these words. Each word that flowers in my ear is like a dagger in my heart.
Oh, go ahead. Tell her a little more, Sonny.
Let us all share our little secrets, shall we? It will prove most amusing. Shall we start with your name, Kira?
Sonny, I have to tell you. My name is not Kira. It's Cleo.
Oh, that's pretty.
Oh, wait, it gets better.
Continue to share, Sister Cleo.
I'm not Australian. See, this is how I usually talk.
Wait, what? Who are you?
Sonny, I am a muse.
Yes, you are. You're my muse. You've inspired me.
All cards on the table now, Cleo.
Well, all right. Sonny, in the modern mortal age in which you dwell, the word muse has taken on a metaphorical use, as a person who inspires another person. I am not that. I am a daughter of Zeus.
What are you saying?
See, she's saying she's a demigod, bonehead.
It's so obvious. Am I the only one here who gets it?
Kira... Cleo or whatever. I don't believe what you're saying.
Oh, wait. It gets even darker. Mel Pomney and I.
Muse of tragedy.
Muse of epics.
We were extremely jealous of our sister.
So we whimsically placed the curse on the two of you.
To fall in love.
What?
You weren't really in love in the first place.
A curse? But it feels so real. Sonny, don't believe them. I really am in love with you.
You know what? That curse part, that sort of makes sense.
What?
You do have to admit, we did fall in love a little too fast.
So afford me a moment of clarity. You don't believe that I am a muse, but you do believe that my sisters here placed a curse on you?
Hey, don't get mad at me. That one on the right looks seriously witchy-poo.
I try to dress simply and let my personality be the star.
But this is real, genuine love.
Can you prove it?
Well, no.
Exactly.
A fie upon you, Sonny Malone!
Fie!
Yeah, fie!
Muses, we return, for we feel something heavy is going down.
All that I offer this mortal, he rejects.
I pity the fool.
Well, you should blush, Sonny Malone, in shame. And to you, my beloved muses, forever there granting encouragement and doing backup. I must confess to you, I have done that which Zeus has decreed is forbidden. I have confessed my very museness to a mortal.
No!
I have also allowed myself to fall in love with this mortal.
Never!
And I have also, in my most blatant defiance of Zeus, created art myself and enjoyed it.
Oh, no, you didn't!
Look, now I've had it. This is weird, this little cult thing you have going on here, but I'm sorry. I don't believe any of you are from ancient Greece.
Dude, we speak in unison, like a Greek chorus. How much proof do you need?
He believes not. Away I go from whence I've come, back into the chalk mural that is crude and amateurish.
Hey.
There Pegasus shall take me to Zeus, that I will be rightly punished.
Then we shall leave also. We shall return to the mural. Let this year, the year 1980, be known as the year all inspiration left the arts.
And we shall leave as well, smug in our confidence.
Goodbye to you, Kira or Cleo or whatever. I really thought we had something here, man. You're riding off on Pegasus' back. You're a nutso.
Sonny Malone. I have to tell you something, but please know that it comes from a place of love. I just cheated you out of a fortune.
Oh. That's okay.
I know that you're going to walk after me with violence, so I have taken the liberty of calling all of my lawyers and... Did you just say, okay?
Kira, the girl... The one who was my inspiration. Turns out she's crazy.
Well, with most people in creative, it's 50-50.
No, like certifiable. She said she was an ancient Greek muse named Cleo, and that she came out of a drawing I did, and now she's gone back to wait for Pegasus to fly her to Mount Olympus.
A muse, huh? That should explain how I have known her long ago, and how she would stay forever young. Maybe my whole life is taking an extreme spiritual turn. That happens to rich people sometimes. Not often.
She's crazy. She said she loved me.
She loved you and not me? Now that's crazy.
My heart is reminded.
is a horse in the sky. It's a horse in the sky!
It's Kira.
Kira is Kitty, and they're both Cleo. That's what life is. Just crazy like that sometimes. I gotta go stop that wrecking ball. You have to go after her.
But it's just a mural on a brick wall.
And when it isn't falling, it looks like banging your head against a brick wall. I gotta go save that thief.
Then I will go to Mount Olympus, even if it's very tall and in the Mediterranean.
Merciful Father Zeus, Hera, wife of Zeus, Thetis, goddess of the sea, and Aphrodite, goddess of love, to beg your forgiveness.
Dearest Cleo, you have given way to the curse of love inflicted upon you by your mischievous sisters. This is a foolishness and a folly which I cannot accept for one of my offspring, and so I must punish you.
But my lord, surely as you have created this child with the goddess of memory, surely you have it in your heart to forgive her?
Their rules I've created, and their rules I must abide by.
For I, Aphrodite, goddess of love, implore you, be lenient with her, for I believe this nut is not a curse, but actual, genuine love.
Never! It is a curse! A curse placed upon her by her sisters! She must suffer the consequences!
I, Thetis, a goddess of the sea, look into the eyes of this child and know that it is not a curse, but actual love.
I know this as well, but my only evidence is my feelings.
She's got it bad. And that ain't good.
I shall now proclaim my sentence. Eternal banishment in the netherworld.
Stay your hand, my lord. I shall present the existence of genuine love that cannot be proved with feelings, but with hard evidence.
What? How?
Impossible.
She proves this? She's good.
Zeus, may I remind you of my son Achilles, the greatest warrior of Greece, and how he was destroyed by Paris, who shot his arrow straight through his Achilles heel, thus killing him. And as you may recall, dear Zeus, all of the gods' offspring are dipped in the river Styx, thus making them impervious to injury, but they are held by their ankles, so that their only vulnerable spot is their ankles.
I remember this, Thetis, but I do not see how...
Master Zeus, I appeal to you. Look at the attire Cleo has donned, the woolen-woven fabric she has placed around her ankles.
The leg warmers!
But of course! No curse can penetrate this demigoddess. Not as long as these mighty leg warmers are on my ankles.
If only I thought that leg warmers were my brave son Achilles.
Then it is true. Love has triumphed. Cleo did truly fall in love with that mortal.
I don't care. She'll be banished anyway.
Oh, my Zeus. My mighty, mighty Zeus. Think with your heart and not your brain.
Thank you.
creature that twists my omnipotent arm. Cleo may live. Let Ovid and Homer take notes. I am indeed Mellow.
No, you will not regret this, merciful father. You will not regret this.
Kira! Kira!
What is that sound? Is that Cerberus, the three-headed hound of Hades?
Kira! I found you in... Whoa. What is this place? Is this some kind of spa?
Oh, Sonny, I am so happy to see you.
I believe you, Kira. I believe everything. I believe you really are a muse, and I believe you do love me. And now I have something for you to believe. I love you, too.
Who is this mere mortal? He is forbidden in the world of gods.
Sonny, do you not know where you are? This is Mount Olympus, where the gods dwell. And this is Zeus and his three attending goddesses.
Oh, yeah, I know this. What? I saw this in a movie once. What was it? Yeah, this is Clash of the Titans!
No, it's not.
Those are all really gods?
Yes, we are gods and we are not a muse.
I don't care. I will fight anyone or anything to be with the woman I love.
You would dare fight me?
No!
Yes, I would. I love her that much.
Well, never seen that before. Someone who loves that much. And Cleo, do you love this mortal?
With all of my heart.
And you would willingly give up your powers, even immortality?
I would.
But Cleo, this is 1980. The muses are in retreat. Creativity shall remain stymied for decades. A theater? They'll just take some stinker of movie or some songwriter's catalog, throw it on stage, and call it a show.
Then I shall take the stage adaptation of the inferior cinematic offering, the musical of the box that is Duke, and I shall take it to remind mankind that there's something greater than wealth or fame, and that is the human experience rendered comprehensible through art.
I love her so much.
I begin my quest on Earth today with a roller disco.
Then so be it. You shall live on Earth as a mortal... and as an Australian.
Thanks, mate.
But before you leave me forever, one final gift.
No! Mighty Zeus, king of the world, keeper of the clouds, Cleo has gotten what she deserved, to live and die in L.A. No further gifts, I implore you.
Let anyone who hears for the quest of Xanadu know that it was epic.
And a tragedy.
Be gone with you! The quest was ended to shun shortly and be happy.
Short and happy? We are outraged! Outraged!
What?
Kira, there's not a whole lot I can offer you. Just that I love you and you can create whatever you want.
Myopic mortal, this is the greatest achievement you could ever wish for. To love someone else and to create art. That is Xanadu!
That is Xanadu!
Open your eyes and see what we have made and reached.
So give it up for him.